Matthew, Matthew. The book of the generation of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Abraham begot Isaac, and Isaac begot Jacob, and Jacob begot Judas and his brethren. And Judas begot Phares and Zarah of Tamar, and Phares begot Esrom, and Esrom begot Aram. And Aram begot Amminadab, and Amminadab begot Nasan, and Nasan begot Salmon. And Salmon begot Booz of Rachab, and Booz begot Obed of Ruth, and Obed begot Jesse. And Jesse begot David the king, and David the king begot Solomon of her that had been the wife of Urias. And Solomon begot Roboam, and Roboam begot Abia, and Abia begot Asa. And Asa begot Josaphat, and Josaphat begot Joram, and Joram begot Ozias. And Ozias begot Jotham, and Jotham begot Achaz, and Achaz begot Ezekias. And Ezekias begot Manasses, and Manasses begot Amon, and Amon begot Josias. And Josias begot Jeconias and his brethren, about the time they were carried away to Babylon. And after they were brought to Babylon, Jeconias begot Salatiel, and Salatiel begot Zorobabel. And Zorobabel begot Abiad, and Abiad begot Eliakim, and Eliakim begot Azor. And Azor begot Zadok, and Zadok begot Achim, and Achim begot Eliad. And Eliad begot Eleazar, and Eleazar begot Mothan, and Mothan begot Jacob. And Jacob begot Joseph the husband of Mary, of whom was born Jesus, who is called Christ. So all the generations from Abraham to David are 14 generations, and from David until the carrying away into Babylon are 14 generations, and from the carrying away into Babylon unto Christ are 14 generations. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise, when as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Then cometh Jesus from Galilee to Jordan unto John, to be baptized of him. And Jesus, when he was baptized, went up straightway out of the water, and, lo, the heavens were opened unto him, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove, and lighting upon him. And lo, a voice from heaven, saying, This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Then was Jesus led up of the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. And when he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he was afterward an hungered. Then the devil leaveth him, and, behold, angels came and ministered unto him. Now when Jesus had heard that John was cast into prison, he departed into Galilee. And leaving Nazareth, he came and dwelt in Capernaum, which is upon the sea coast, in the borders of Zabulon and Nephthalim. And there followed him great multitudes of people from Galilee, and from Decapolis, and from Jerusalem, and from Judea, and from beyond Jordan. And it came to pass, when Jesus had ended these sayings, the people were astonished at his doctrine. For he taught them as one having authority, and not as the scribes. When he was come down from the mountain, great multitudes followed him. And when Jesus was come into Peter's house, he saw his wife's mother laid, and sick of a fever. And he touched her hand, and the fever left her, and she arose, and ministered unto them. And when he was entered into a ship, his disciples followed him. And, behold, there arose a great tempest in the sea, insomuch that the ship was covered with the waves, but he was asleep. And he entered into a ship, and passed over, and came into his own city. And he arose, and departed to his house. And it came to pass, as Jesus sat at meat in the house, behold, many publicans and sinners came and sat down with him and his disciples. And Jesus arose, and followed him, and so did his disciples. But when the people were put forth, he went in, and took her by the hand, and the maid arose. And the fame hereof went abroad into all that land. And Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues, and preaching the gospel of the kingdom, and healing every sickness and every disease among the people. But when he saw the multitudes, he was moved with compassion on them, because they fainted, and were scattered abroad, as sheep having no shepherd. And when he had called unto him his 12 disciples, he gave them power against unclean spirits, to cast them out, and to heal all manner of sickness and all manner of disease. Now the names of the 12 apostles are these: the first, Simon, who is called Peter, and Andrew his brother, James the son of Zebedee, and John his brother, Philip, and Bartholomew, Thomas, and Matthew the publican, James the son of Alphaeus, and Levius, whose surname was Thaddeus, Simon the Canaanite, and Judas Iscariot, who also betrayed him. And it came to pass, when Jesus had made an end of commanding his 12 disciples, he departed thence to teach and to preach in their cities. Then began he to upbraid the cities wherein most of his mighty works were done, because they repented not. But when Jesus knew it, he withdrew himself from thence, and great multitudes followed him, and he healed them all, and charged them that they should not make him known. Then was brought unto him one possessed with a devil, blind, and dumb, and he healed him, insomuch that the blind and dumb both spake and saw. The same day went Jesus out of the house, and sat by the seaside. And great multitudes were gathered together unto him, so that he went into a ship, and sat, and the whole multitude stood on the shore. And he did not many mighty works there because of their unbelief. When Jesus heard of it, he departed thence by ship into a desert place apart, and when the people had heard thereof, they followed him on foot out of the cities. And Jesus went forth, and saw a great multitude, and was moved with compassion toward them, and he healed their sick. And he commanded the multitude to sit down on the grass, and took the 5 loaves, and the 2 fishes, and looking up to heaven, he blessed, and brake, and gave the loaves to his disciples, and the disciples to the multitude. And they did all eat, and were filled, and they took up of the fragments that remained 12 baskets full. And they that had eaten were about 5,000 men, beside women and children. And straightway Jesus constrained his disciples to get into a ship, and to go before him unto the other side, while he sent the multitudes away. And when he had sent the multitudes away, he went up into a mountain apart to pray, and when the evening was come, he was there alone. But the ship was now in the midst of the sea, tossed with waves, for the wind was contrary. And in the 4th watch of the night Jesus went unto them, walking on the sea. And when they were come into the ship, the wind ceased. Then Jesus went thence, and departed into the coasts of Tyre and Sidon. And Jesus departed from thence, and came nigh unto the Sea of Galilee, and went up into a mountain, and sat down there. And great multitudes came unto him, having with them those that were lame, blind, dumb, maimed, and many others, and cast them down at Jesus' feet, and he healed them. And he commanded the multitude to sit down on the ground. And he took the 7 loaves and the fishes, and gave thanks, and broke them, and gave to his disciples, and the disciples to the multitude. And they did all eat, and were filled, and they took up of the broken meat that was left 7 baskets full. And they that did eat were 4,000 men, beside women and children. And he sent away the multitude, and took ship, and came into the coasts of Magdala. Then charged he his disciples that they should tell no man that he was Jesus the Christ. From that time forth began Jesus to shew unto his disciples, how that he must go unto Jerusalem, and suffer many things of the elders and chief priests and scribes, and be killed, and be raised again the 3rd day. And after 6 days Jesus taketh Peter, James, and John his brother, and bringeth them up into an high mountain apart. And was transfigured before them, and his face did shine as the sun, and his raiment was white as the light. And, behold, there appeared unto them Moses and Elias talking with him. While he yet spake, behold, a bright cloud overshadowed them, and behold a voice out of the cloud, which said, This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased, hear ye him. And when the disciples heard it, they fell on their face, and were sore afraid. And when they had lifted up their eyes, they saw no man, save Jesus only. Then the disciples understood that he spake unto them of John the Baptist. And Jesus rebuked the devil, and he departed out of him, and the child was cured from that very hour. And Jesus called a little child unto him, and set him in the midst of them. And it came to pass, that when Jesus had finished these sayings, he departed from Galilee, and came into the coasts of Judea beyond Jordan. And great multitudes followed him, and he healed them there. Then were there brought unto him little children, that he should put his hands on them, and pray, and the disciples rebuked them. And he laid his hands on them, and departed thence. And when the 10 heard it, they were moved with indignation against the 2 brethren. And as they departed from Jericho, a great multitude followed him. And the disciples went, and did as Jesus commanded them. And brought the ass, and the colt, and put on them their clothes, and they set him thereon. And Jesus went into the temple of God, and cast out all them that sold and bought in the temple, and overthrew the tables of the money changers, and the seats of them that sold doves. And the blind and the lame came to him in the temple, and he healed them. And he left them, and went out of the city into Bethany, and he lodged there. Now in the morning as he returned into the city, he hungered. And when the multitude heard this, they were astonished at his doctrine. And no man was able to answer him a word, neither durst any man from that day forth ask him any more questions. And Jesus went out, and departed from the temple, and his disciples came to him for to shew him the buildings of the temple. Now when Jesus was in Bethany, in the house of Simon the leper, there came unto him a woman having an alabaster box of very precious ointment, and poured it on his head, as he sat at meat. And the disciples did as Jesus had appointed them, and they made ready the Passover. Now when the even was come, he sat down with the 12. And when they had sung an hymn, they went out into the Mount of Olives. And he took with him Peter and the 2 sons of Zebedee, and began to be sorrowful and very heavy. And he came and found them asleep again, for their eyes were heavy. And he left them, and went away again, and prayed the 3rd time, saying the same words. And while he yet spake, lo, Judas, one of the 12, came, and with him a great multitude with swords and staves, from the chief priests and elders of the people. And, behold, one of them which were with Jesus stretched out his hand, and drew his sword, and struck a servant of the high priests, and smote off his ear. And they that had laid hold on Jesus led him away to Caiaphas the high priest, where the scribes and the elders were assembled. But Peter followed him afar off unto the high priest's palace, and went in, and sat with the servants, to see the end. Now the chief priests and elders and all the council sought false witness against Jesus, to put him to death. When the morning was come, all the chief priests and elders of the people took counsel against Jesus to put him to death. And when they had bound him, they led him away, and delivered him to Pontius Pilate the governor. And they took counsel, and bought with them the potter's field, to bury strangers in. Wherefore that field was called, the field of blood, unto this day. And when he was accused of the chief priests and elders, he answered nothing. And he answered him to never a word, insomuch that the governor marveled greatly. Now at that feast the governor was wont to release unto the people a prisoner, whom they would. And they had then a notable prisoner, called Barabbas. Then released he Barabbas unto them, and when he had scourged Jesus, he delivered him to be crucified. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into the common hall, and gathered unto him the whole band of soldiers. And they stripped him, and put on him a scarlet robe. And they spit upon him, and took the reed, and smote him on the head. And after that they had mocked him, they took the robe off from him, and put his own raiment on him, and led him away to crucify him. And as they came out, they found a man of Cyrene, Simon by name, him they compelled to bear his cross. And when they were come unto a place called Golgotha, that is to say, a place of a skull, they gave him vinegar to drink mingled with gall, and when he had tasted thereof, he would not drink. And sitting down they watched him there. And set up over his head his accusation written, This is Jesus the King of the Jews. Then were there two thieves crucified with him, one on the right hand, and another on the left. The thieves also, which were crucified with him, cast the same in his teeth. Now from the sixth hour there was darkness over all the land unto the ninth hour. And straightway one of them ran, and took a sponge, and filled it with vinegar, and put it on a reed, and gave him to drink. Jesus, when he had cried again with a loud voice, yielded up the ghost. And, behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain from the top to the bottom, and the earth did quake, and the rocks rent. And the graves were opened, and many bodies of the saints which slept arose, and came out of the graves after his resurrection, and went into the holy city, and appeared unto many. And many women were there beholding afar off, which followed Jesus from Galilee, ministering unto him. Among which was Mary Magdalene, and Mary the mother of James and Joses, and the mother of Zebedee's children. When the even was come, there came a rich man of Arimathea, named Joseph, who also himself was Jesus' disciple. He went to Pilate, and begged the body of Jesus. Then Pilate commanded the body to be delivered. And when Joseph had taken the body, he wrapped it in a clean linen cloth, and laid it in his own new tomb, which he had hewn out in the rock, and he rolled a great stone to the door of the sepulchre, and departed. And there was Mary Magdalene, and the other Mary, sitting over against the sepulchre. In the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulchre. And, behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven, and came and rolled back the stone from the door, and sat upon it. His countenance was like lightning, and his raiment white as snow. And for fear of him the keepers did shake, and became as dead men. And they departed quickly from the sepulchre with fear and great joy, and did run to bring his disciples word. Now when they were going, behold, some of the watch came into the city, and shewed unto the chief priests all the things that were done. So they took the money, and did as they were taught, and this saying is commonly reported among the Jews until this day. Then the 11 disciples went away into Galilee, into a mountain where Jesus had appointed them. And when they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted.